The show is doing really well in Indonesia, and I'm so happy to be here in the mall for the meet and greet, because the way they shout your name, they're so happy to see us, to come take pictures, because they love our show. So I'm very happy, and I'm glad that I came to Indonesia, and I hope to come here again and again to meet my fans.
Same goes with me. I'm very happy. Literally, I'm very happy being here in between such a huge family I have here in Indonesia. I didn't know about it. I'm so happy to be here. Thank you so much, everyone, for all the love. It actually did really well in India also, and
but in Indonesia it being dubbed here in Indonesian Basi language, and still loved by so many people, and it's the number one show.
Yeah.
So I'm I can only thank all the fans for loving us, for liking our show, because on this show we worked really very hard, day in, day night. We worked for 18 hours, 20 hours, and finally, you know, when it's not only popular in India but now also in Indonesia. So, you know, all the efforts that we put in making a show, in working so hard, is fruitful and becomes fruitful when you have such lovely fans and giving us so much love and the show.
So thank you for loving our show
here. Bilang, di sana juga merupakan show yang besar dan ratingnya juga tinggi. Jadi mereka di sini senang kalau misalnya dapat mendapatkan hal yang sama,
tinggi. Firstly, I'd like to thank MTV to organize the whole thing for us. I really wanted to go to the orphanage and meet those underprivileged kids. It's very sad, but the best part, when I reached there, I saw everybody was smiling. Everybody was very disciplined, which shows that, you know, whoever is taking care is really giving them good education and teaching them well. You know, it's not easy to come up without parents. We all have had the privilege, and God's been kind, but, you know, life is not very fair. But I would say that we, as human beings, people who are underprivileged or are, you know, under orphanage, we got to make sure that they get a life, they value their life, and they get the right education. So please donate everybody to different orphanages, and please provide them with food, water, whatever, clothes, books, whatever you can. Please go to these orphanages once in a month and meet them, spend time with them. I think you all have given me so much love without knowing me. So I would request, give a lot of love to those children also, and to those old people also who are left alone.
When I went there, it was a totally different atmosphere, because every child was smiling, and that smile was from the heart, so pure and so beautiful, kids. It was like I was not feeling like going back from there. I just want to say that they all are really brave, and whoever, as Arjun said, is taking care of them has taught them well, good manners and good discipline, because every child was very disciplined. And God bless them.
Okay. Jadi dari jawaban Arjun, pertama-tama dia mengucapkan terima kasih buat MTV karena udah memberikan kesempatan buat mereka berdua untuk dapat mengunjungi panti asuhan ini. Saat perasaan dia saat melihat panti asuhan ini, pertama dia senang karena dia bisa melihat meskipun mereka ada dalam keberadaan yang kurang beruntung, namun setiap anak itu dapat tersenyum bahagia dari hatinya, kayak tulus senyumnya, murah senyum segala macamnya. Dan juga dia punya pesan untuk semua orang yang ada di luar sana, bagi semua orang yang punya kehidupan yang lebih, atau ini semoga bisa mengajarkan mereka, memberikan mereka banyak donasi seperti buku, baju, ataupun makanan. Dan juga pengen bilang juga kepada pengurus panti asuhan di situ, katanya mereka tuh memberikan pendidikan yang sangat luar biasa ke anak-anak ini, karena saat melihat anak-anak ini tuh sangat disiplin, Jadi dan dari Anisha sendiri, dia juga berpendapat yang sama bahwa anak-anak ini tuh tetap tersenyum meskipun dalam keadaan yang bisa dibilang kurang itu. Dan dia tuh merasa kayak nggak belum pergi dari sana karena energi di sana semuanya tuh sangat positif.
Why not? I think you know, it's a great audience here, and eventually as actors you want to entertain, you want to make sure that if I ever get a chance to do something big there, I will definitely do it, and I think it will be my honor to do it in a different country, and as well as it will be very challenging for me as an actor to do a show here because the language is very different. So but whenever I do it, I'll work really hard with the same amount of passion that I've done my other show.
It will be another challenge as an actor, and I would love to do it.
Jadi sama jawabannya buat mereka berdua. Mereka pengen karena sebagai aktor mereka juga butuh tantangan tertentu. Terutama kalau bisa dapat acara di sini, pasti kan ada tantangan dalam itu. Itu nggak bakal menghalangi mereka untuk berhenti menjadi aktor.
Well, we met a lot of people. Yeah. Which is great. That's why we were here. We wanted to meet our fans. So that was the best part about coming to Indonesia. We did a lot of activities which people will see on NTV and the YouTube channel of NTV. We stopped by a mall just seeing Indonesian brands and
and we also played games there, the traditional games of Indonesia.
And I ate this chocolate donut from Indonesia. It was really, not donut, croissant from Indonesia. It was really tasty. I've had the godu godu.
That's wonderful.
Then yesterday I made the katopra. And I also had the chicken satay with peanut sauce. So the overall experience right from I got out of the airport till the time, till today, till coming to this mall has been absolutely amazing. I can't express it in words. You know, they've been calling me Indonesian channels since a very long time. But I couldn't come because of my shooting schedule. But I'm so happy I finally made it. I think God always wanted me to be here and see how much love I'm going to get.
Jadi beberapa hari ini ya yang dia lakukan acara-acara di Amerika, dan kemarin dia juga baru ada acara syuting bikin ketoprak, terus dia udah nyobain makanan sate gado-gado dan macam, dan di sini itu benar-benar pengalaman yang luar biasa buat dia. Jadi semua semoga bakal ada kesempatan buat
dia. The Dobra, so it was a game we were playing and there were a few ingredients. And they were saying the names of those ingredients in Bahasa, and we had to guess out of that ki which things to put. And then first we made the sauce with the ingredients, then we put all the solid food, whatever is to be put in the katopra.
And he was mixing everything with all hard work.
Yeah, and then finally I made everybody taste it, and it was very tasty. Yeah, not exact, tasty, but very close to what katopra actually
is.
Jadi ini sebenarnya sebuah tantangan, jadi harus gitu, harus ditonton nanti pas udah tayang di YouTube. Jadi dia bikin ketoprak kayak dari mulut sampai jadi, habis itu dia suruh semua orang nyobain bikinannya.
Honestly, I've made quite a few characters, but I wanted to play a Muslim character because I have not played that till now. I know a lot about the culture, and inshallah, by God's grace, God willing, soon I want to play that role because the culture is different, the mannerisms are different, and I think it will be a challenging thing to do as an actor. Whichever, it can be a Muslim cop or it can be anybody, like a love story. Would love to do a love story actually. So yes, I think that would be interesting.